Ladies and gentlemen,
Psycho Dad
will not be seen tonight, so we may present the All Barbara Special. Stay tuned as Barbara Walters interviews Barbara Streisand, Barbara Bush, and then Barbara Streisand again.
No Psycho Dad? How can this be, Peg? What moron is behind this?
Hey, Al, what gives?
Did they take off Psycho Dad on your TV, too? Oh, hey.
Hey.
Ranch style.
Stand back, kids. Huey, Dewey, and Ewey are here.
Men, listen up. They've canceled Psycho Dad.
What?
Yes! And you know who's behind it?
Women?
No! Marcy Darcy Chicken at Large. Well, I say there's no way we'll give up our Psycho Dad.
What can we do?
Let's use the power of our giant, manly brains.
Ma, they've been like that for hours now. Should we get the jumper cables?
No need.
I got it! We'll picket the TV stations. Once the word gets out, our fellow men will come from every part of the country. Men, gather the troops. This will be the biggest demonstration Chicago has ever had.
Yeah!
Bring back the feeling in my feet.
All right, take a 2-minute break.
How long have we been here?
Counting the break? 2.5 minutes.
Hey, Al, I've got an idea. Bob Rooney's got a heated garage.
Yeah, and he's got the profile of a manatee, too. What's your point?
Well, we could protest there and be warm.
Protest in Bob Rooney's garage. But how can we be sure our message will reach the people?
We'll leave our signs outside.
Genius.
Yeah. What would Psycho Dad do if he were one of us?
He would, he'd take some women hostage and make them do laundry.
No, Psycho Dad don't have no laundry. He's been wearing the same psycho suit for 7 years.
And now he's hanging it up for good.
Well, we can't just sit here and let it happen.
What do you want us to do? We're not going back to Ice Station Zebra again.
No. I'm taking this fight to the place that stands for liberty. That stands for freedom of expression.
The nudie bar?
No. Well, maybe first. Then we're going to our nation's capital. Gentlemen, no ma'am is going to Washington!
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the United States Senate.
Look at it, guys. This is where it all happens. The power, the intrigue, the chicks.
Look, guys, there is no way the U.S. Senate is going to put aside the important business of running this nation to discuss something as moronic as Psycho Dad.
We'll have to table this debate on the Arab-Israeli peace accords. The men from No Ma'am are here to lobby on behalf of Psycho Dad.
We are really going to have to discuss your past.
Would the group approach the chair and take a seat, please? Good morning, gentlemen. My name is Senator Furman. and I am chairman of the Presidential Subcommittee for Taste in Television.
Hey, Al, Taste in Television. T-I...
Shut up!
And you six are here to argue on behalf of a television show that was recently canceled due to excessive violence, namely Psycho Dad. Now, who will begin?
I will, sir. Remember, Al, short and to the point.
Yeah, and don't say anything that'll make us look stupid.
Nope. No problem. Senators and senatorettes. Since man has evolved from the mighty Adam, he has searched endlessly for two things. The other is entertainment. Entertainment was easy for the simple caveman. Man brought home food. Woman, burn it. Giant pterodactyle swoops down, chases woman, she falls in mud. A good laugh was had by all.
Sit down, Mr. Bundy.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Anyone else? You there with the moons.
Yes, sir.
Well, we just think you should bring back Psycho Dad because, well, he symbolized everything that's great about this country. I mean, like take the time he went charging into that Indian village that was filled with unarmed women and children, right? So he's blasting away.
What the total stranger standing beside me is trying to say is nobody talks about the good side of Psycho Dad.
Gentlemen, is it not true that the lyrics to the Psycho Dad theme song in part reads, he's quick with a gun, but he loves his son, so he killed his wife because she weighed a ton?
In Psycho Dad's defense, when he married her, she wasn't fat, your bigness.
What happens now?
Well, unfortunately, Griff, the wheels of justice move very slowly.
We've reached a decision, Mr. Bundy. Violence is not acceptable in a civilized society. Psycho Dad's gone, and this meeting is adjourned.
Take it easy, Griff. We might have lost Psycho Dad, but we will win the war.
It's not that. To tell the truth, I never even liked Psycho Dad.
Well, what is it then?
I really thought we were going ice fishing.
Hello, my name is Brian Leone. The following story you are about to encounter may disturb you. Many believe nearly 4.5 decades ago, there was born a man from half human and half psycho. It is said from the years of the lunatic ravings of his insane mother that something happened to the frontal lobe of his brain in the small urban town where he grew up. Residents still shaping fear whenever the story is told. The story is of Psycho Dad.
You remember that time? It might have to be back in the 50s, 40s, when Psycho Dad was just born.
I heard about that.
Dude, he shot out like a bat out of hell.
Yeah, and he knocked out like 5,000 people and like knocked out a wall.
Remember that crazy Dr. Dave?
Yeah, that guy was on Time Magazine. Man.
I just remember a white coat.
Yeah, we found out later he was doing all those insulin shots and stuff, taking stuff from the back.
Yeah.
Remember that? That was crazy.
Yeah, he's the one that shot that Mark McGuire guy with steroids.
That was the beginning. The beginning of Psycho Dad.
Yes.
Come on.
Oh my God!
You're just freezing my head and
Jesus Christ, I'm trying to read.
What? Help me!
Am I the one with
the head?
Look at her!
What?
Look at her!
What?
Look at her!
Oh, she's out.
Look at her!
Wait, she
I'm
has a baby?
Baby!
Wait, that comes in.
Who
come
are you?
Out?
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Dave!
Ah! You're breaking my head!
Okay.
Seriously.
Do something!
Do what? Well, you want me to
something!
Do I can do this? I can do this, huh? You want me to dance around?
Hey!
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
You got cigarettes all over you! You're an asshole! You're getting all over my hospital bed! All my hospital bed! its cause?
Run! She's just an object. You know what? She's an object.
I'll show you up there.
That's not true.
Jose, are you kidding? Are you sure? Jose, are you kidding?
Hey, I went once in there. I'm not going again, okay? It's not even mine. Not even mine.
Come on. Come on, baby. Please, we can't do it. No one can. Please, yeah. Woo! Come on.
I'm glad I'm not an object.
Push.
Oh my god. It's a psycho boy.
Man, I gotta re-deal this hand.
Well, yeah, I just thought of...
What?
Remember Psycho Dad's dad?
Oh, he was crazy.
Yeah, the cigar face, I think his nickname was.
Cigar face.
Yeah, I think he has syphilis too, right?
Oh.
No, that was Al Capone.
Oh.
Psycho Dad, as a child, threw that log, and it hit that car, and he's like, "Did you kill him?" And he was just always rooting on his son to
that's
do
kidding.
Bad things.
It's a strange way
that legend. Seen. That's how the legend was born. That's how.
Great job, son. Did you kill him?
Legend.
Yeah.
Man, he was a real man's man.
Yo, remember that time his psycho dad's mom was like, clean your room, and he was like, nah, and like duct taped her to a pole.
Dude, that was so amazing. Yeah. He's my hero for things like that.
Yeah, that's why I killed my ball if I was acquitted, so I say whatever.
Dude, she was screaming and yelling and panting and raving and doing all this, that, and the other, and he was just like,
for Christ's sake, can't you just clean up your goddamn room?
Teach you not to tell me to clean my room, Ma. I mean, when a woman is duct taped like how Psycho Dad did to his mother, I mean, she just deserved it.
I think she deserves it.
I
was laughing like hell. I was over in the next house. Man, you know, I was pretty young.
I was the next town over, I think, when it happened. I mean,
I heard about it, man. I was laughing, pissed.
First you can't clean your own room, and now you can't even clean your own dishes!
That stuff about violence that went through.
Yeah, he was a very violent kid. Remember that time when, I don't know, I guess it just... came out and he ran out of that that fence. He had like that Batman fence that came off the hinges, and he used to just come out of there like a crazy man. That's why I guess he was called Psycho Dad, and he just hit that unsuspecting oncomer and knocked him over. He fell on that garbage can.
Nope.
It was kind of funny.
SATs. What's the thing?
Oh, remember Psycho Dad? Dude, he's a true legend, that guy. Oh, man, he didn't even care. He wanted those women at those smart colleges.
Yeah, who told him?
I think somebody said something about, like,
like something about going there to hot girls at like really smart colleges, so he took his SATs and just whacked that kid. That was funnier than hell. Yeah.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, about 5 more minutes left to the end of the SAT.
Upsetting you guys?
Yeah.
What? I tried to go to college once, and that damn bastard, Psycho Dad, remember when he stole that kid's SAT?
That
was
like 14, 50, 27, 60, 24. Somewhere around there. It was
14. I think that's a high end score.
That's a Heineken right there.
Yeah. Now your look at it's mine! Yeah, not yours! Mine now.
Alright, man. You're in your own little world.
I call her Mike. That's her name.
Well, what was the school he went to?
That Ron Slayer?
Ron Slayer?
Ron
Saller?
Saller?
Saller. I think it's Saller.
It was in Troy.
Hey, come back, Data.
Roy?
And
some guy named Roy is probably the president.
Well,
Roy,
remember how he said the thing about, like, his friend told him something like there's a lot of hot girls when he's 16 and go to college.
That's like really hot.
Like,
he was watching that Babes Gone Wild and College Girls.
Yeah.
Oh, just
crazy stuff on
that. Yeah, you used to have to get that like on those super discs.
But I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but why did you choose that Ron Sauer? I mean,
yeah, there ain't nothing there.
There's
Sasquatch used to run through them parts.
Yeah.
Oh my god! This is empty. Yeah, but Sasquatch, I'll tell you that, Harry.
There was Sasquatch and Fastmatch and all those things. Oh, and then he got pissed off and he went on that killing spree. Oh, I don't know how he got out of that one.
Alright, you guys, where are all the girls?
We're at RPI, dude. There's no girls here.
Oh, man.
Puts food on the table and working man. Working man puts food.
Damn straight, mother trucker.
I wish I was a working man. I'd just sit here and play cards all the time.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta get your hands dirty.
Yeah.
To be a true working man. You know what I mean? Like how we said about cars.
Yeah.
What?
Psycho Dad used to be a working man. He used to be out on those cars all day, all night.
Yeah. Man, he would work on. I'm ringing. That rings a bell because I remember he'd be there in that garage, or if it was, you know, when he didn't have a garage, he'd be outside. He'd be on the ground every minute.
Every minute.
When the daylight right.
Where the hell's my steak dinner, woman?
here's your friggin' steak dinner, and here's your dessert, you ass.
What the hell kind of steak dinner is this? What the hell's that? Here, I'll give you game steak dinner. Here.
Well, you know, there's an end to every story.
There is.
And,
Tony, I swear to God, I'll get it to you.
And,
I swear to God, Tony.
The thing.
Don't cut off my legs. Tony. Please, Tony.
Alright.
Tony,
hey,
you gotta cut off my legs.
There's an end to what he's saying.
Cut you. Off my leg, back to the old Scotch or whatever I'm drinking. I don't even
but
know
anyway,
anymore.
There's. The way he ended things, as we were saying before, the middle begins to the end.
Remember when he ended it with his wife?
Yeah. Yeah.
That damn frying pan is.
Right,
he had that
right
his
out.
Whole life.
Listen, pig face, you ate your dinner and you threw your dishes all over the floor. Put them in the goddamn dishwasher, all right, Jermaine? Why are you so sloppy for? Everything's all over the goddamn house. Clothes are all over the house. You don't help me with nothing. Why don't you pick up the vacuum once in a while, huh? What's the matter? You can't push it around a little bit? It's a big pigsty over here. Why don't you go in the back and pick up the dog poop? Go get a garbage bag, get a shovel, and get the freaking poop. It's this high.
Here's the bag. We'll pick up the dog shit. Who's that riding into the sun? Who's the man with an itchy gun? Who's the man who kills for fun? Psycho Dad! Psycho Dad! Psycho Dad!
Let's talk that psycho dad, whatever happened to him?
No one, I don't think anybody really ever know what happened.
Right.
He just rode off into that sunset.
No one really knows what happened to psycho dad. But many have claimed to see him.
See, I think he's my lawn guy. He did such terrible work, my lawn is all eaten up and I had to fire him. And then he came back and now he was my window guy. And he started fixing my windows. I didn't even tell him to fix my windows. I don't even know why he fixed my windows. Then he wanted $2,000, and I told him to come back in a month and I'll pay him. But he never came back, so God knows where he is now.
That crazy man was here a couple months ago, and he came in here complaining of a toothache, and we ended up trying to pull his tooth. There was blood and pus coming out of his mouth. He got upset with me because he felt something, and he ran out of here.
Psycho Dad was walking across the street, and a school bus ran him over. And then they drug him inside the bus and they drove away. So then we see them banging on the glass saying, help me, get me out of here, get me out of here. But I don't know where he went. They drove away with him.
And many people believe that this man is Psycho Dad.
And do stuff. The dog stepped in the dog shit and brought it in the house. You can't even go outside and pick up the poop and throw it out. I've asked you a number of times, can you do some housework while I'm at work? Because it's all you do is sit here on your goddamn lazy ass and do nothing. Can't you get off your ass? Why don't you go do the dishes? Why don't you go do the goddamn, get the hell out of here, get out of my face. So I'm sick of you doing nothing. Go do something.
I need to go get some groceries after this and stuff like that.
I mean,
what are you guys doing? Cards and games.
I'm getting my legs cut off, all my limbs cut off, I mean.
I'm tired.
This guy right here, he's got
some problems, man.
My ears got scratched. Him.
Dad. He's quick with a gun, but he loves his son. Killed his wife cause she weighed a ton. He's a dope dad.
A little touched or so we're told. Killed his wife cause she
he was getting old. Psycho Dad, Psycho Dad, Psycho Dad. He's quick with a gun, and his job ain't done. Killed me once by 21, he's Psycho Dad.